السلام عليكم. In our previous hadith reading series, we discussed باب العلم قبل القول والعمل. ثم باب كتاب العلم of صحيح البخاري. العلم قبل القول والعمل. It is essential to know, that is ilm, knowledge, before saying or acting, before qawl or amal. Amal means yes, deed, deed, a powerth, yeah, deed, work. Qawl, words, or yeah, words. So before acting or saying, you have to know something, we should have a knowledge about that thing. Then, under that bab, we read some hadiths and some verses. One hadith: "Man salaka tariqan yatlub bihi ilman, sahhala Allahu lahu tariqan ila al-jannah." You read that hadith.
فَمَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَطْلُبُ بِهِ عِلْمًا سَهَّلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ.
Yes. Meaning. مَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَطْلُبُ بِهِ عِلْمًا سَهَّلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever. مَنْ سَلَكَ
followed a way to seek knowledge,
yes,
Allah will make easy for him way to
the way tariq to paradise, tariqan ila jannah. Man salaka tariqan, whoever sought or whoever entered into the way, into the path, yatulub bihi ilma, that is to seek knowledge, ilm, then sahhala Allahu lahu, Allah will make easy for him tariqan, a way or path, ila al-jannah, to the paradise. Yes. Next. Under that bab, Imam Bukhari quoted one verse from Zumar, Surah Az-Zumar. هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون. You recite.
هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون.
يعلمون 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 والذين لا يعلمون. Meaning.
Are those who know equal to those who know not?
Yes. Next. In another hadith, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من يرد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين.
من يرد الله به يفقهه.
من يرد الله به what? من يرد الله به خيرا
يفقهه في الدين. وإنما العلم بالتعلم.
من يرد الله به خيرا. If Allah wished khair, virtue, goodness for a person, then what will Allah do? يُفَقِّهُهُ فِي الدِّينِ. He will make him comprehend in his religion. وَإِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ بِالتَّعَلُّمُ. And certainly, ilm. Ilm means?
Knowledge.
Knowledge. He is بِالتَّعَلُّمُ by? Knowledge is gained by? Learning, ta'allum, yes, ta'allum, learning. Learner is called muta'allim. And who teaches is called mu'allim. Allama yu'allimu, mu'allim. Ta'allama yata'allamu, muta'allim. Okay. No, next. Next bab. Bab, ma kana nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yatahawwaluhum bil maw'idhati wal ilmi kay la yanfiru.
Ah.
chapter, Bab. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to take care of people in preaching by selecting a suitable time so that they might not run away. Kay la yamfiru. They might not run away. Nafar. That is, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to select certain days or time to preach the religion. Maw'ilah means maw'ilah, advice, good advice. Then ilm means knowledge, sell out. Then, so to preach the religious knowledge, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam selected certain days or certain time. He will not teach all the time. Then they will be get bored. Okay, so that's why he used to preach the people by selecting a suitable time. So, or suitable days, suitable time like that. And under that bab, two hadiths are there. عن ابن مسعود قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتخبرنا بالموعظة في الأيام كراهة الصامة علينا. الصامة, صامة means صامة, yes, boredom, boredom, bore, boring. This ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه reports it is the prophet نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم used to take care of us in preaching by selecting a suitable time so that we might not get bored. We might not get bored. The suitable right time and the right place. He will preach. He will preach. Prophet will preach us at the right time. Selected times. Okay. So, not all the times. Not all the times. He will use a suitable time to preach the right things. Okay. So, it's a methodology of teaching also. Methodology of education, methodology of teaching. The learner's attitude, the learner's condition also should be taken into account. And the all conditions should be taken into account. Then the knowledge, that knowledge which is suitable for that particular time, will be given. Like that. Or suitable time will be selected. To all the time. Okay. Then only the listener, the learner can understand or grasp things. Otherwise, they will get bored. Okay. Next, another hadith. And Anasin and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, yassiru wa la tu'assiru wa bashiru wa la tunaffiru. This hadith we have seen in another portion earlier. Anas radiallahu anhu narrates, make things easy for the people. Yes, siru. Yusir means? Yes. Yes. Easiness. Right. Allowed. Or its opposite?
Sira.
Yusir. Its opposite is? Usir. Usir. You know? Surah al-Inshirah. Besides. There comes innama al-usri yusra. Innama al-usri yusra. Usr means difficulty. Yusr means easiness. So, with every difficulty, there will be an easiness. A way out. Okay, you got. Usr and yusr. Usr means difficulty. Yusr means easiness. So, asara means to make it difficult. To make one thing difficult. Yassara means to make one thing simple or easier. Okay. So, Qala, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded or ordered, directed the people, yassiru, you make things easier. You make things easier. Don't make things complex. وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا and do not make things difficult for the people. Okay? You make things simple or easier for the people. Yeah? And don't make things difficult or much complex. More complex. Okay? Then, وَبَشِّرُوا and you give glad tidings to the people. Glad tidings. Bashir. One who gives glad tidings is called Bashir. Mubashir, one who gives glad tidings. Mubashira, your name. Mubashira, the girl or the woman who gives glad tidings. It's called a Mubashira. Okay? Mubashira. In masculine form, Mubashir. Mubashir, Mubashira. Like that. Mubashiru. Bashara yubashiru. Mubashirun. Mubashiratun. Like that. Mubashir is milfari. مبشرة اسم الفاعل مؤنث. Okay. Feminine form. Masculine form مبشر. وبشروا أمرفة. Okay. أمر command. Direction. Request. Like that. وبشروا and you give them glad tidings. Here it is a direction or command by the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to his followers. ولا تنفروا and do not make repel them. Do not make people repel from your religion. This is much complex, much difficult to observe. So such a feeling should not be created in the minds of the people by the da'is, propagators of Islam. So we should make things easier for the people. That doesn't mean we can cut down the things in Islam, the wajibat, you can cut down, not like that. So here the meanings, do not make things difficult for the people and give them glad tidings and do not repel them. Okay. Next, باب من جعل لأهل العلم أياما معلومة أيام معلولة معلومة. Whoever fixed a special day for giving religious talk to the students. So, suitable time will be selected by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give the people knowledge, to impart knowledge. Like that. Suitable, certain, particular, fixed days will be selected sometimes. Here, one hadith is there. عن أبي وائل narrated by أبو وائل قال كان عبد الله يذكر الناس في كل خميس فقال له رجل يا أبا عبد الرحمن لوددت أنك ذكرتنا كل يوم قال أما إنه يمنعني من ذلك أني أكره أن أملكم وإني أتخولكم بالموعظة كما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتخولنا بها مخافة السامة علينا. That is, أبو وائل رضي الله عنه narrates. قال, he said, كان عبد الله يذكر الناس في كل خميس. That is, Abdullah, a scholar, Sahabi. Abdullah used to give religious talk to the people on every Thursday. يوم الخميس means Thursday. يوم الأحد. يوم الأحد. يوم الاثنين. يوم الأحد. Sunday. يوم الاثنين.
Monday.
Monday. Like that. يوم الثلاثاء. Tuesday. يوم الأربعاء. Then Wednesday. Then يوم الخميس. Thursday. يوم الجمعة. Friday. Then يوم السبت.
Saturday.
Saturday. No? أصحاب السبت. Now, you have seen in Quran. Training series, Surah Al-Baqarah. Those who transgressed the Sabbath day, Sabbath observation for the Jews, Yehudis. Then, so Yawm al-Khamis. So, Abdullah used to take or give religious talk to the people on every Thursdays. So, he selected Thursday for the timetable. Okay. Then, فَقَالَ لَهُ رَجُلٌ. Then One man asked or said to the to Abdullah, Ya Aba Abdurrahman, O Abu Abdurrahman. That means Abdullah. Okay. لوددت أنك ذكرتنا كل يوم. That. By Allah, I wish if you could preach us daily. If you preach, if you teach us daily, I wish for that. I wish this particular man asked the teacher, that is Abdullah, that he, I wish that if you preach us daily, it will be better. I wish for that. Who said? One man said to Abdullah. Abdullah. Okay. Then. Takara means to remind, to preach. Takartana kulayumi. Kulayumi all days. Okay. Kala. Then Abdullah said. So Abdullah used to preach people on which day?
Thursday.
Yes, Thursday. Thursday. Then this man asked him, Lavadittu annaka dhakkartana kulayum. Lavadittu annaka dhakkartana kulayum. I wish that if you preach us all days, it will be better. I wish for that. Then, qala Abdullah Saj, in reply, Ama innahu yamna'uni min dhalika anni akrahu an umillakum. Wa inni atahawwalukum bil maw'udati كما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتحولنا بها مخافة السامة علينا. The only thing which prevents me from doing so is that I hate to bore you. That. أما إنه يمنعني. منع means to prevent. منع means to prevent. To prevent. تريغا. أريد. لا مانع لما أقول. After صلاة. He said the dhikr, Allahumma anta as-salamu minka as-salamu ilayka yarji'u as-salam. Hayyana rabbana bis-salam wa adkhilna dar as-salam. Tabarakta rabbana wa ta'aliyati ya dhal jalali bil ikram. Allahumma wa Allah, la mani'a lima a'tayt. There is no preventer. There is no one to prevent. There is no preventer. Lima a'tayt. That which you have granted. Okay. La Allahumma la mani'a lima a'tayt. Wa la mu'tiya lima a'tayt. And there is no giver. No one can give what you prevented. Okay? Because you remember. Yes. Mana'a means to prevent. Okay. Ama innahu yamna'uni min dhalika. So, that the only thing which prevents me from doing so. From doing so means from preaching all the days. So, the only thing that which prevents me from teaching or preaching you all the days is that anni akrahu an umillakum. Akrahu. Anni akrahu. Certainly I akrahu. Kariha means to hate. Ahabba means to hubb. Hubb Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes. Yes. Ishtam in Malayalam. In English. Like or more better. Better. Good. Love. Uhibbuka, I love you. Uhibbuka, I love you. Okay. Mahabbat. No. Mahabbat. No, all my people apart. Almost all my people apart. You see this. You hear this word, Mahabbat. Can't remember. Mahabbat. Ishq. So, here. Anni akrahu. Suddenly I hate that an umillakum, that I to bore you. I hate to bore you. So when I preach you should listen me. All the people, not one or two. Sometimes this particular man who asked him, maybe loving his words all the days. Okay. But he is addressing a group of people. Okay. Then. So, the only thing that which prevents me from doing so, that is from preaching all the days, is that I hate to bore you. Anni akrahu an umillakum. Amalla means to make one man bored. To make one man distracted. or distracted. Okay, then unattracted, not disattracted, unattracted or distracted. Okay, then وإني أتخبركم بالموعظة. And so I take care of you in preaching by selecting a suitable time. So I will select a suitable day or suitable time like that. كما كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتخبرنا بها. So just as Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do with us. So Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in his days he used to preach us by selecting certain days or occasions like that. Time. So like that I also do want to do like that. Then so that the audience will not be bored, will not be get bored. Okay. So if I take these lessons all the days or all the times or 3-4 times a day, Quran learning series or Hadith learning series, what you will think of me? Ah, what a father. No time to play. Okay. All time he is preaching, he is teaching. Then you will not be get attracted in these lessons. Okay. Okay. It will be like that. Most often it will be like that. This man's nature is like that. So continuous teaching. Then man will get bored. Okay. كما كان رسول الله كما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتخبرنا بها. That is, as the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do with us. For what purpose it is done? مخافة السامة علينا. That is, for fear of making us bored. So Prophet feared. The people will get bored with his lessons. Okay. Then, so he was a good teacher. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was a good teacher. He did knew the teaching methodology. He did know the teaching, good teaching methodology. Okay. He was a good educator, a good teacher. Okay. Next. Babu may yuridillahu bihi khayran yafaqihuhu. So are you getting bored? No? No, are you getting bored this lesson? No. Simply saying, may yuridillahu bihi khayran yafaqihuhu. Chapter. If Allah Jalla Jalal wants to do good to a person, you have seen this hadith earlier in the other bab. Babu al-ilmu qabla al-qawli wal-amal. Okay. Then. Yeah. Also. Man yuridillahu bihi khayran yafaqihuhu fi din. If Allah Jalla Jalalu wants to do good to a person, he makes him comprehend in his religion. That is the understanding of the Quran and as-sunnah. Sayings and ways of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is called sunnah. Then حدثنا سعيد بن قفير قال حدثنا ابن وهب عن يونس عن ابن شهاب قال. So ابن شهاب narrates قال he said حميد بن عبد الله قال حميد بن عبد الرحمن حميد بن عبد الرحمن said سمعت معاوية خطيبا يقول. So معاوية رضي الله عنه. I heard. سمعت means I heard. سمع means heard. Hear, to hear. Okay. Sami'atu, I heard. I heard Muawiyah radiallahu anhu preaching the people or giving oration. That is speeches. Okay. Speeches. He was giving speech to people. Then, yaqul. Then, in his speech, Muawiyah radiallahu anhu was saying what? Sami'atu al-Nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul. I heard, who said? Muawiyah radiallahu anhu said in his speech. And this was heard by حميد بن عبد الرحمن. Okay, in his speech, Muawiyah says, in his speech, Muawiyah says that سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. I heard Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying what? What did Prophet say? من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. وإنما أنا قاسم والله يعطي. ولن تزال هذه الأمة قائمة على عمد الله لا يضرهم من خالفهم حتى يأتي عمر الله تن. من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. That is. If Allah wants to do goodness to a person, He will make him comprehend in his deen, ad-deen, al-Islam. Then, Prophet said, وَإِنَّمَا أَنَا قَاسِمٌ وَاللَّهُ يُعُضِي. I am just a distributor, but the grant is from Allah. I am a distributor, just a distributor to you. That is, I am Qasim. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I am Qasim. وَإِنَّمَا أَنَا قَاسِمٌ. Qasama means to divide or to distribute things. So here Prophet said, وَإِنَّمَا أَنَا قَاسِمٌ. Suddenly, I am just a distributor of knowledge. But وَاللَّهُ يُعْطِي. But the grant is from Allah. I am given this knowledge from whom?
Allah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I am giving you the knowledge. I am distributing the knowledge. Prophecy. So I am only a distributor. وَإِنَّمَا أَنَا قَاسِمٌ. I am a distributor of knowledge. A giver of knowledge. وَاللَّهُ يُعْطِي. And for me, Allah gives this knowledge. Okay. Allah, but Allah is the grander. Allah gives me. Okay. Grand knowledge. وَلَنْ تَزَالَ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةُ قَائِمَةً عَلَىٰ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ مَنْ خَالَفَهُمْ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ. Then, the real followers of that this nation or and remember that this nation or this ummah, the real followers of Islamic monotheism will remain, this ummah will remain obedient to Allah's orders and the Prophet Sunnah, then and they will not be harmed by anyone as long as this ummah strictly follow the Quran and Sunnah, then they will not be harmed by any other people from outside. Okay. Anyone, by anyone, those who oppose them. Man khalafahum. Khalafa means to oppose. To oppose. To act against. Okay. Hatta ya'ti amrullah. Till Allah's order is established. Till Allah's order is established. So, if the ummah follow Quran and Sunnah strictly in their life, then the ummah has nothing to fear, or the ummah should have, there is no need to fear the attack from outside, from those who oppose Islam and Muslim. Okay, oppose, to act against, khalafa, to oppose. Okay. No. باب الفهم في العلم. The superiority of comprehending knowledge. Fahum means understanding. Fahum means understanding, to grasp things. So if one preach things in the audience, to the audience, to a group of people, all will not comprehend at the same level. Some will comprehend better, some at a lower level. Okay? It will be like that. That is called a fahum. Fahum means to understand. Understanding. Fahum. Mujahid رضي الله عنه قال, he said, صحبت ابن عمر الى المدينه فلم اسمعه يحدث عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الا حديثا واحدا. قال: كنا عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فاتي بجمار فقال: ان من الشجره شجره مثلها كمثل المسلم، فاردت ان اقول هي النخله، فاذا انا اصفر القوم، فسكت. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: هي النخله. Similar hadith we have seen in another bab. This the report was from Ibn Umar or Ibn Abbas. I don't remember. No. Then somewhat similar. The verse like this. Then here Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu narrates. Firstly, this Mujahid narrates, written by Mujahid radiyallahu anhu. Qala, he said, Sahibtu Ibn Umar ila al-Madina. I was accompanying Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu to Madina. Falam asma'uhu yuhadithu an Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam illa hadithan wahida. Then I heard him, I heard from Ibn Umar, this Mujahid radiyallahu anhu was accompanying with Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu to Medina. They were together. They were going to Medina. Okay. Then I heard. Who said? Says Mujahid. Allah says. Yeah. I heard him say the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I didn't hear him hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam except one. Except one hadith. At that time. Okay, that means he heard one thing, one hadith. He didn't hear a hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Ibn Umar at that time. Means at that time, except one thing means he heard one thing. Okay, one hadith from Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu. Then la haditham wahida. Qala, he said. Kunna inda Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this verse by Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu. Okay. Kunna inda Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fa utiya bi jummar. We were with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and fa utiya bi jummar. We were sitting with the, we were with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu says. Okay. This verse he said to Mujahid radiyallahu anhu. When both of them were going to Medina. Okay. Kunna inda Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We were with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fa utiya bi jummar. Then a spadix, a log of date palm tree was brought there. A spadix, a wood of date palm tree. Date palm, you know, in Malayalam?
Indapara.
Yes. That date palm tree, a spadix of date palm tree was brought there. Spadix, it's in the was brought there. Then فَقَالَ then Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said إِنَّ مِنَ الشَّجْرِ شَجْرَةً مَثَلُهَا كَمَثَلِ الْمُسْلِمِ. Then amongst the trees there is a tree which resembled a Muslim. Amongst the trees there is one tree which resembles, it is like a Muslim. Which resemble means it like, it looks like a Muslim. It resembles a Muslim. Then فَأَرَدْتُ أَنْ أَقُولَ. Then I kept فَأَرَدْتُ أَنْ أَقُولَ. I intended to. I wished, I hoped, or I intended to say هِيَ النَّخْلَ. It is the date palm tree. I intended to say. In mind, but didn't say. فَإِذَا أَنَا أَسْأَرُ الْقَوْمِ فَسَكَتُ. But I was Sagir. Among the little people. So I was little, or I was a small boy, or I was younger of them. Among the group, I was younger. Then فَسَكَتُ, I kept silent. Yeah, I kept silent. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, هي النخلة. Is the date palm tree. So what is there? Here, what is the importance of this resemblance? Or why, how it resembles to a Muslim? Or how a Muslim resembles a date palm tree? A date palm tree will be evergreen. Eh? Like that, a Muslim will be evergreen. He will give knowledge. He will give impart knowledge to the people. Eh? All the times. That doesn't mean he will sit and before a group of people and preach all the time. Not like that. His life will be helpful to impart knowledge to others. Eh? Seeing his life, others will understand good things from his life. Okay? Also, he will preach. He will preach also. Eh? Not always. But his life will be benefited. Eh? Other people will be benefited from his life all the time. Eh? Just like a nakhla. So, this nakhla, it will give fruits to the people. Eh? It will keep as ever, it will be evergreen. Okay? So this much for today. Assalamu alaikum.